Welcome in LaTeX tutorial, and today I'll talk about figure and sub-figure in LaTeX. Here I have a very simple document. Document class is article, and then title, author, and make title. Actually, adding of any graphics in LaTeX is very simple. We need to add one package which is known as graphics, and then we need to use one command which is known as include graphics. So first add graphics package in the preamble. And after that we can add any graphics with the help of include graphics command. For example, I want to add one image, this one. So just we need to write include graphics command. And in a curly bracket we need to write file name. So this one img13. So if I write img13, and we can write extension of the file. This is JPG, and just compile the file. It's coming, as you can see, but it's very large, so we can reduce. So for adding any image, I have some instructions. Here I have some instructions. First we need to add this package, graphics package, and we can use this command for adding any image, include graphics, and in a curly bracket we need to write file name. And in a square bracket we can set the image size, and we can also rotate and crop the image. So we can write width f and backslash text width or line width or column width if you are using more than one column document. Okay, for example, you can write width equal to 0.5 line width. That means graphic size will be reduced to 50% of the total line width of the document. Okay, here we can also write height argument, and then here we need to write text height. Okay, we can also reduce the size with the help of scale argument in the square bracket. Okay, for example, if I write scale equal to 0.5 in this square bracket, that means image area will be reduced to 50% of the total area. We can rotate our image in the text file directly with the help of angle argument. Okay, we can crop with the help of trim argument. Trim equal to, we can write left, bottom, right, and top, and clip option. Some more instructions are also there. Just put the image in the same working folder. If graphics has a white spacing, then crop all the white spacing from all side. Okay, next, add image either before starting the paragraph or after ending the paragraph. Okay, this is the best way to add graphics in the document. And if you are adding image from the separate folder, then you need to write path here, or you can use a graphics path command. Okay, in the preamble. Now in a square bracket I'll reduce the size, so I'll write scale 0.1, 10% of the total area. As you can see, that size has been reduced. We can also write caption for this image, so with the help of a figure environment. So we need to write begin figure and end figure, and after that just write caption. And just compile the file. You can see that. We can also put the caption and image in the center of the page. So after begin figure, just write here centering. And compile this file. Right, we can label this with the help of label command. This key we can use for cross referencing. Okay, for example, here if I write and compile this file, that one is coming. Now next, we can set the position of this image with the help of specifier, position specifiers. Okay, inside square bracket we set the position. You can use single specifier or combined specifier. Here T is used for keeping the float at the top, B for bottom, P is used for keeping the float at a particular page for float only. H can be used for printing the float at a place where you want to print. Exclamatory can be used for overriding the specifier. Capital H or H with exclamatory can be used for forcing the float at a place where you want to print. And TBP can be used for printing the float at a top or bottom of the page. This is the default specifier. Okay, another specifier you can also use. I use h for here. As you can see that here we can change the label of the figure. Figure name we can put in bold. So with the help of caption command package. Okay, just write here caption, and in a square bracket just write font. Sorry, label font equal to BF. BF means bold font. Sorry, bold face. Now you can see figure label is coming in bold. We can change the font of the caption. We can put font equal to small, so size will be small. Alright, next point is that we can put this caption in a side of the figure. So with the help of side cap package, so here we now just write here side cap. But in this case you will have to write SC figure environment rather than only figure environment. Okay, so if I write here SC figure, I just copy and paste. Here I write SC, there should be in capital, this is in capital. Now we can compile, it's running. Now you can see that caption is coming in the side of the image. Okay, and if you are using Tech Studio, then you don't need to write every time whole environment. Okay, for example, I want to add one image, this one, so you need to just drag and drop at that source file. Okay, drop at the place where you want to add, and after that one small window will come where you can set the image width and height. Okay, some other settings are also there. We can put the image in the center, we can put figure below the graphic or above the graphic. For example, I want to add a caption at the above of the graphic. We can write caption, label name is automatically coming, so don't need to do anything. And position we can also set, click there, you will see several options. So we can put top or bottom, so I choose top bottom, and then press it OK. Okay, and then we can compile. 0.5. We can also generate list of figures, so just need to write here list of figures and then compile your file. And also we can use a sort title for this list. So after the caption in a square bracket just write here sort title. Now I'll talk about sub figure in LaTeX. We can put multiple figures side by side with the help of sub caption package. Here we need to write sub caption. Just write use package sub caption. You can also use sub figure and sub figure. But these two packages have been deprecated and they are not used nowadays. So I'll just comment this. And I'll use sub caption, this is widely used. Okay, okay, so I want to add this figure and this one side by side, and after that centering, and after that we need to write sub figure environment. Okay, I have two images, one image will take almost 50% space, but we need to write little bit smaller of the available width. Okay, so I'll write here 0.45, not 0.5, and then we need to write line width. You can also write text width. Okay, and here just put image, this one I want to add, so these three lines I'll copy and just paste here, change the label. In a similar way I'll add this one, this one. Okay, so just copy this one and paste here, and just change the name of this image. This is img 15. Image label you can change. So it's very simple, just need to write figure environment. Okay, and then we'll have to use sub figure environment. As you can see, sub figure include graphic, caption label include graphic, and then compile your file. Okay, so we need to set here width of the image. So here I'll write width equal to total available line width. So total available line width is 0.45. So 0.45 for this image. Okay, and same thing I will paste here, and again compile this file. Okay, even images are not coming side by side because of this blank line. If I remove this blank line and then if I compile, you can see that images are coming in side by side. Actually, we can set the space between the images. Okay, here we can use quad. Okay, other options you can also use Q quad, or you can use H fill. You can also set the alignment for the sub figures. After begin sub figure, you just in a square bracket just write B. B for bottom alignment. In both sub figure need to write B. You can use T. T for top. Okay, here we can also use global caption for these two sub figures. So after last sub figure, we need to write caption, and we can label this and then compile your file. So as you can see that caption and sub captions are coming. In a similar way, we can also put tables side by side. So I'll write here one example. So here you can see that I have used here begin table, end table, caption for whole tables, label, begin sub table and end sub table, caption for this sub table, label. This is width for two tables. You can use 0.45 of total line width. For three, you can use 0.3. And caption for this subtable, label, and begin tabler, end tabler. Here you can put your table. And in a similar way, I have put for second table. Okay, and then compile this file. As you can see that first table and second table. And for table, we can create list of tables. So that's it. Thanks for watching.